Greetings everyone, welcome again in Forgotten Mechs. To refresh the topic, it is about battle mechs that you rarely see on the battlefield these days, either chassis or some particular variant of it. You still see them from time to time, once per several games, maybe. But they are not very popular, not like mudcats, grasshoppers or piranhas. Well, stay till the end. I will show you the builds. Also, I usually link interesting videos there. Cataphract 4X. 4X. How mighty have fallen. There were times when this mech stood proud next to Banshee 3E, Stalker 3F and the others. Well, very few others, because game was young and we only had couple of mechs. Long time ago, right after the dinosaurs, it was popular back then. Four ballistic mounts, the only mech in the game that had four ballistic mounts capable of mounting something like quartet of AC5s or duets of AC5s. And AC2s, godlike level of firepower back then. When pop tarting became a thing, Cataphract 3D proudly took the baton from hands of 4X and stepped into the light. It didn't kill 4X. Still, nothing could compare with it in ballistic department. But more and more meta shifted, and other mechs were added to the game. And slowly, but surely, 4X stopped showing its ape-like arms on the battlefields. Because that was and still is the problem with the battlemech. Arms. They are so low, guys from the hood nod in approval and rap music is coming from your speakers. You can do only one thing in this battlemech, utilize ballistic mounts. And for that, you need big, open terrain. Yes, you need to stand in the open. For every pop-tart, lermer, sniper, or 70 alpha laser vomit chad to see you. And by stand I do mean stand, because your max speed is 57 km per hour. And it is as close to standing as possible in this game. And since selling point here is ballistic DPS, you can't really twist all that much. You start to see the problem. All cataphracts have the same problem. They can be corner fighters, but even slight road bump will be your mortal enemy. So, what role can 4X fill today with its ballistic setup? Sniper? Long-range DPS? Sure, stand there in the open, exposing entire silhouette. Let's see how long that will last. Trading mech with 20 alpha. First 70 alpha Hellbringer will walk over you before you crest the hill to expose those arms. Brawler then. Well, your arms can't fit 20 caliber weapons. Go brawl with 10s. Who am I to stop you? Cataphract is dead, and no weapon balance will fix that. You can play it for nostalgia reasons only. And sometimes, gods of war smile upon thee, and enemy forget that with 4AC5 you still have massive and more important pinpoint DPS. Because it's only Cataphract. What danger can this pile of scrap pose? You drive this mech for that sweet games when they let you do your thing. Well, while I was talking, my team reduced the opposition to piles of damaged pixels. And for sure, they do not have enough duct tape to come back from that. Credit where credit's due, he still got the kill. Well, that's pretty much it. Just remember, none of this should really happen. This should not work this way. You saw me exposing my entire mech for an entire game, and no one was really shooting at me. Clearly, I had some kind of plot armor. You do not have it. Don't try this at home. Well, as promised, those are the builds. There will not be many of them, because there is not much possibility here. This one is more often used, if you can use that word in association with Cataphract. 4 autocannon 5, light engine 250, and 6 ton of ammunition. In the match, we used this build. Pretty much the same, but you are swapping 1 ton of ammo and some armor for 1 light PPC. There is another one, as Yoda could say, autocannon 10 and autocannon 2, pair of each, and ammunition for it. This one is for decidedly short engagement. You need to aim your shots well or you will run out of ammunition. Well, that's it for today, folks. If you liked this video, comment, share, subscribe, and see you next time.